Dear children, welcome to the video class. Grade 10 Science Unit 2 Chapter 9. Dear children of Grade 10, it gives me an immense pleasure to meet you in this video class. Today we are going to start the 9th chapter in biology. So I already told you, in the reduction of portions, we have only 9.2 heredity alone we have. Okay, yes, now all of you take your page number 143 and come to the topic 9.2, heredity. So what is meant by heredity? Okay, so what is meant by heredity? For this you know the reason, isn't it? So what is meant by heredity? The passing of characters from one generation to the other generation is called heredity. Okay, so the passing of characters of the father to the child or mother to the child is called heredity. Okay, have you all understood the definition of heredity? Okay, that is the passing of characters or the passing of traits from one generation to the other generation is also called heredity. Okay, I think so you know the definitions. Okay, now we are going to see some of the rules by which the traits are inherited. Okay, so what is meant by traits? Okay, now this is a new word for us, isn't it? Okay, what is meant by traits? Okay, traits means it is nothing but characteristics of features. Okay, traits means it is nothing but characteristics of features. For example, if your grandmother is having the curled hair, means the child will be also having the curled hair. So that is the feature. Okay, if the grandmother is short or if the father is short, means the progeny. The progeny means the child will be also short. Okay, so this is one of the traits. Okay, so what is meant by inheritance? Okay, inheritance means the passing of characters. Okay, the other meaning of inheritance is heredity. Okay, have you all understood, children? Now we are going to see the rules how the traits are inherited from one generation to the other generation. Okay, now come to the topic 9.2.1. Okay, a simple example is given in your book. Take the figure 9.2. Okay, so these two traits we have seen in the society. Okay, come to the figure A. Figure A is free earlobes. Okay, see the lowest part of the ear, so that is called the earlobe. Okay, this is free, this is not attached. In the B you can see attached earlobes. Okay, in the A you can see free earlobes and the B you can see attached earlobes. Okay, so people in the human population, we have these two variant societies of people. We have seen these traits in different people. Okay, so what does it mean? If the child is having the free earlobe, means her parents, her mother or her father or her grandfather or her grandmother will be also having the free earlobe. If the child is having the attached earlobe, means her father or her mother or her grandfather or her grandmother will be having the attached earlobe. Okay, so what does it mean? For example, let us consider a situation. The father is having the attached earlobe. Okay, the father is having the attached earlobe. The mother is having the free earlobe. Okay, but the child is having the attached earlobe. Okay, how the character is inherited? The character is inherited from the father, not from the mother. Okay, have you all understood what is inheritance? That is, inheritance means how the characters are transferred. Traits means some of the characters such as tallness, shortness. Okay, then free earlobes, attached earlobes, curled hair. So this and all traits. Okay, children, have you all understood? Now we are going to see the rules for the inheritance of traits. Okay, what are the rules are there for how the traits is inherited? Okay, now we can see the human beings. Okay, if we look at small baby, means it looks like a man. Okay, it looks like a pop human. Okay, it has same eyes, it has same hair, it has same legs, it has two legs, two hands. Okay, so everything, it looks like a human being, but there is some changes. Okay, there are some changes in the shortness, in the heightness, then in the color. Okay, so that and all, we are going to see how they are inherited. Okay, see children, the first point is, okay, the trait can be influenced both by paternal or maternal DNA, paternal or maternal DNA. Okay, what they are saying, that the trait can be influenced, it may be either paternal or maternal. Maternal means if you are getting from the mother, means that is maternal. If you are getting a characteristic from the father, means that is paternal. Okay, you can also see, you can consider your own example. If you are resembling your mother, means your trait is inherited from the maternal DNA. If you are looking like a father, means your trait is inherited from the paternal DNA. Mostly all the girl child, they will be looking like mother. Sorry, they will be looking like the father. Okay, mostly all the male child will be looking like the mother. Okay, now let us see with the help of the Mendel experiments. Okay, Mendel. So who is Mendel? Means he is a great scientist. Okay, now let us consider Mendel, Gregor Johann Mendel, in 1822-1844. Okay, so he is a scientist as well as he is a mathematician. Okay, so what he did, means he has failed in his examination. Okay, then after failing in this examination, he left that and he went to grow peas. Okay, peas, you know what is meant by peas? Peas means patani. Okay, so using that scientific knowledge and the mathematical knowledge, he looked out how the characteristics are inherited in peas. Okay, in peas. By that, he derived many laws of inheritance. Okay, you can learn this in your book. Take your book and learn. This is a very, very interesting story. Okay, you can learn and you can get many informations also. Now, have you all understood, children? Shall we pass on to the next one? Okay, now let us come to the main point. Okay, so Mendel, he took a number of contrasting characters. Okay, contrasting characters means easily visible characters. Okay, such as round and wrinkled seeds. Round seeds and wrinkled seeds. Wrinkled means, you know, konja surukama. Then tall and short plants. Okay, so one plant is tall, other plant is short. Then white and violet colors. Okay, so like that, he took many pea plants and worked on them. Okay, and he produced progeny from them. So what does mean by progeny? Here also we are getting one of the term, progeny. Progeny means offsprings. Okay, progeny means offsprings. Offsprings means children from them. Okay, that is the children in the next generation. For example, your father and mother, they are giving birth to you, know, so you are a progeny. Like that, what he did, he took many plants, okay, of visible characters such as tall and short, white and violet, round and wrinkled, and he produced progeny in them, and he calculated how the characters are inherited, which is dominating and which is recessing. Okay, have you all understood, children? Okay, now let us come to the experiments 9.3. Okay, this is very important. Listen carefully. Okay, he took tall plant and he took a short plant. Okay, he took tall plant and he took the short plant. Okay, here the father is father and mother are tall and short plant. So the tall is represented by TT, capital T, capital T. And the short is represented by small tt. Okay, small tt. Okay, so we got the first generation as TT, capital T, small t. Okay, capital T, small t. But all the plants were tall. Okay, but all the plants were tall. Okay, have you understood, children? Okay, so what he found, what he took? He took a tall plant and the short plant and he found the progeny in them. And he found the offsprings in them. He found that all the plants were tall. Okay, he found that all the plants were tall. Okay, so how they are represented by small capital T and small t. Okay, here a question to you, children. Here there is no medium sized plants. Okay, that is the tall plant and short plant is the father and mother, and we are getting the first generation offsprings. That is the first generation progeny as all the tall plants say TT. Okay, there is no medium sized plants or there is no short plants. All the plants produced were tall only. Then what he did, he took the F2 generation. Again, you took the same plant in the F1 generation, that is TT. Okay, and he produced self-pollination in them. Children, we have already studied what is self-pollination, isn't it? Go through what is self-pollination. Okay, so he produced self-pollination and he got the progeny for the F2 generation. Okay, so what he did, the progeny of the F1 generation is allowed to self-pollinate and he obtained the progeny for the F2 generation. In that, he found one quarter of the plants was short and other was tall. Okay, so how this arises? Where this, see, children listen carefully. Okay, here only we have the short, okay, but in the F1 generation there is no short at all. Okay, see, again from the F1 generation are asked to self-pollinate, here also there is no shortness inherited, but see here the shortness stripe was inherited. Okay, so what does it mean? Okay, so what does it mean? Means the inheritance was from the parent itself. Okay, but here it was in the dominant one, so it was expressed in the F2 generation. Okay, have you all understood, children? Okay, now see, come to this one, children. In the F1 generation, okay, TT and TT are tall plants, isn't it? This is in the F1 generation, TT and TT are small plants. Okay, then in the F2 generation, small TT is a short plant. Okay, so what does it mean? Means a single copy of capital T is enough to produce a tall plant. Okay, so if there is no a single copy of T, means if there is not even a single copy of small T, means it will be a short plant. Okay, so what does it mean? Capital T is the dominant trait. Okay, capital T is the dominant trait and small T is the recessive trait. Okay, capital T is the dominant trait and small T is the recessive trait. Okay, have you all understood, children? Okay, so go through that and you can get some information. Okay, now come to the next one. Okay, then he took some of the plants and he obtained progeny. Okay, he took tall plant with round seeds. Okay, he took tall plant with round seeds and short plant with wrinkle seeds. Okay, he took the tall plant with round seeds and short plant with wrinkle seeds and again he obtained the progeny. Okay, from the progeny he stole that the F2 progeny. That is, in the F2 progeny, he obtained tall and round seeds and a very few also with short and wrinkle seeds also. Okay, so what does it mean? What does it mean? That is, the tall or short trait and the round and wrinkle trait are independently inherited. It was same thing. Okay, so you do it as a homework. Okay, if there is any doubt, we can clarify in the next class. Okay. Now we are going to see how the inheritance of traits for two visible contrasting characters. Okay, that is the inheritance of traits for two visible contrasting characters. So what he meant, it means he took the pea plants with two contrasting characters. Okay, so what does that mean? One with round and green seeds. Okay, one with round and green seeds. Okay, so other with yellow and wrinkle seeds. Okay, so the round is denoted by capital R. Okay, so it is green, no? So it was denoted by small y. Okay,
then the wrinkle is denoted by small r,
and the yellow is denoted by capital Y. Okay, then he obtains some progeny. Okay, progeny for the effort generation. Okay, so what happens means here R and Y is contributed, that is capital R and small y is contributed. Here capital Y and small r is contributed. So we are getting capital R small r, capital Y small y. I already told you only one capital is enough for producing a trait. So capital R is there, so we will be getting round, and capital Y is there, so we will be getting yellow round progeny in the first one generation.
Okay, have you all understood till then? Okay,
then he allowed for cross pollination. Okay, then this is allowed for cross pollination. Okay, that is R, capital R small r. So capital R is there, so it will be round in nature, and capital Y is there, so it will be yellow in nature. So it is allowed for, that is the F1 generation is allowed for self pollination. So what we are getting means we are getting, okay, round and yellow, and round and green, and wrinkled and yellow, and wrinkled in green in the ratio 9:3:3:1. Okay, so what does it denote? Okay, in the F2 generation, so we are getting 4 characters. Okay, so we are getting 4 characters in the F2 generation, isn't it? So they are independent of others. They are not dependent on the first generation. They are independent of others, and we are getting 4 different characters. Okay, children, have you all understood? Okay, so this is very important. Okay, so you have to see. Now we are going to see how the mechanism of heredity work. Okay, so how this heredity is worked out means because of the protein which is in the DNA. Okay, the cellular DNA is the information source for making protein in the cell. Okay, so now we have seen about the tallness and shortness, isn't it? How a plant will be tall. So it is because of the plant hormones that trigger the growth, isn't it? Yes, this is only because of the plant hormones that trigger the growth. Okay, now if the plant is tall means there are some plant hormones that trigger that growth, and the efficiency is also depend upon the how the enzyme is secreted in a plant, and the how the enzyme helps the gene to make an alteration in the characters. Okay, so what does it means genes only control the characteristics or traits. Okay, children, have you all understood, children? Okay, children, go through this properly. Okay, this is a new topic to you. Okay, go through this carefully. If you have any question, you can message me or you can raise in the meet class. Okay, I will explain you in the meet class. Okay, do this. I will show you the activity. Do this and submit me. Okay, children. Dear children, your activity for this class is you write the answers for the questions 1, 2, 3 in page number 147. Then your next activity is you have to frame 20 MCQs, that is multiple choice questions, in 9.2.1, 9.2.2 and 9.2.3. Okay, children, do your activity and submit me within 5. Okay, children. Thank you, children. Have a nice day. Meet you again in the next class.